But you know, folks, I'm still glad that God has kept me in my strength today. Amen. Greater is he that's in me than he that's in the world. Right and wrong thinking and little thoughts, stinking thinking. So, you know, sometimes, folks, we can pray and see someone healed, and if they don't change their thinking, then the enemy will attack them. If they don't renew their mind, then they're going to become sick again. And I know some won't believe that, but folks, the enemy is there. If he could steal our salvation, he would. I remember when I got the baptism of the Holy Ghost, he said, "You ain't getting no Holy Ghost." And I said, "Just let me speak in tongues." Amen. And still do, folks. Paul said, "I speak in tongues more than y'all, but in the presence, in the assembly, I dare speak 5 words that people could understand than 10,000 words in an unknown language." It says, we can't receive from God if our thinking is wrong. You know, the enemy will do everything in the world to keep us from receiving God's best. Today, I will not settle for less. I want God's best for my life, and I'm going to seek after it, I'm going to dig after it, I'm going to chase after it, I'm going to pray after it, fast after it, whatever I got to do, but I want God's best. And folks, we can't have God's best if we don't have knowledge of God's Word. The psalmist said, "Thy Word have I hid in my heart that I might not sin against you." So it's important that we have the Word of God. But Joshua said, "This book of law, so you shall meditate upon it both day and night, so shall you make your way to prosper, so shall you have good success." So it's important that we renew our mind. Protect your mind, by number one, by what you see. The psalmist said, "I'll set no unclean thing before my eyes." Moses endured the cross as seeing him who is invisible. To Joshua and Caleb, they could see the giants, but also they could see God as God being bigger and mightier than they were. How do we see Jesus today? Do we see him high and lifted up, the Lord God of hosts, the God of armies? Today it's important how we see Christ. And I know there'll be spiritual giants that we must face. And Paul to the Corinthian church said, "I was with you in weakness and fear and much trembling. And my speech is not enticing words of man's wisdom, but in demonstration of the Spirit and power, that your faith would not stand on the wisdom of men, but on the power of God." So Paul said, "I was with you in weakness and fear and trembling, and a little thought, do it afraid." You know, even though you're afraid, preach the gospel. Even though you're afraid, take a stand. Even though you're afraid, and you know, we're almost taught that there's no fear. But folks, there's a time that we have fear. There's a time that we're afraid of persecution. We're afraid of rejection. But folks, I want to be on God's side. Amen. And I want God to be on my side. Amen. And so do it afraid. Take a stand for God, and God will stand with for you. To protect your mind about what you see, protect your mind about what you hear. Faith comes by hearing. When we're around people of faith, and our faith will soar. And boy, I like that, don't you? When we hear confessions of doubt and unbelief, then we become doubtful and fearful. You know, to Christ sent them out two by two. And usually, and Brother Gibbs said, usually not two people are down at the same time. Thank God, ain't it? You know, to Miss Taylor, the time I get discouraged, I go to her, and boy, she won't have it. She said, "Jerry, you've preached faith to me all these years, and God's going to make a way." Amen. 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 So you know it's important, folks, that we go to someone. You know, I could have went to a different person, and we just could have had us a pity trip. I mean, we could have had a pity party. I could have got a whole bunch of doubters and powders around, and we could have just played in a little mud hole. Brother Glenn talked about spiritual mud holes and said people were playing that, and said, "Oh, we're just splash, splash, splash." But said there's a whole lake just over the side of the mountain, Brother Bill. So you know, why play in a mud hole if there's a river? Amen? Yeah. But we need to protect what we hear. And folks, it's important that we speak faith. You know, a friend was talking about going to the poorhouse and things. But folks, we need to, our mindset that we're going home to where the blessings of God are. We're going home to a sanctuary. We're going home to where the angels camp out. You know, Sister Osborne said there's campfires all about her house, if you could see in the spirit. And because there's angels camp out at her house. A little lady out on East 80 prophesied to Sister Auburn and said, "I see campfires." And she didn't know that Sister Auburn had done told us about them campfires. So, folks, it's important that we protect our mind on what we hear. And I want to hear words of faith and encouragement. I want to hear that how that they overcame. Amen. That they didn't, the devil didn't overcome them, but they overcame him. They overcome persecution. They overcome doubt. They overcome sickness. They overcome their failures. They overcome their heartache today. Number three says, what we meditate on, what you think on and think on and think on. The book of law says, you meditate day and night, so shall you make your way to prosper, so shall you have a good success. Don't use your mind for a garbage can. The little thought, trash in, trash out. Trash in, trash out. So, folks, if you put garbage in your mind and in your heart, then that's what's going to come out of your mind and out of your heart. But if you'll focus upon God's Word, and you know, I thank God that for, you know, almost 30 years, you know, I read the Bible and I read commentaries and devotionals and different things trying to renew my mind. And there's a lot of things that I won't read. And there's a lot of things I wish I had never read. Teaching on false doctrines and cults. Teaching on them for a while, and I said I wouldn't even read that stuff if I didn't have to teach it.